sure. I think, you know, the president has made clear that, you know, he's not focused on 2012 at all. And I think that's the right decision because we have big problems and opportunities. And if you're thinking about the election as a prism through which to view that, you're not going to do what's best for the country. So there'll be a time for the campaign. We just got done with the last one a year ago. So there'll be a time for that. All I can say is, you know, a lot will change in the intervening 2 or 3 years. We'll have to see where things stand at that point. The campaign is draining. Now, I would argue that when we went through the campaign, nothing seemed as tough as that. What he's trying to do now is obviously, by a huge degree, much more difficult. But it's draining just because, again, we were just talking about time. Elections have deadlines, whether they're individual primaries, fundraising deadlines, the general election, registration deadlines. So you've got to maximize your time. And this race was intensely covered. So I think all of us, for 2 years really, and there was no let up, laid everything we had out on the field. That included our volunteers, who many of them had a job or two jobs, and then somehow they'd find 15, 20, 25 hours a week to spend on the campaign. It was a remarkable display and something that was so important in the campaign. So, but listen, I believe so strongly in what the president's trying to do, the kind of campaign we ran that got so many people involved for the first time. So it was tiring, but it was well worth it.
You talk about several times in the book the mood of the candidate, that it really does affect a performance.
And we were blessed. I mean, I've worked in politics for a long time, for some great people, maybe some not so great people. You know, and I guess this is true with leaders of any organization. You know, they tend to have idiosyncrasies. You know, they can have moodiness. We didn't really have that with then Barack Obama, now President Obama. He was just very normal. And so you didn't have to wake up every day worrying about, you know, how he may react to things. We just, listen, a campaign is a collection of human beings, like any organization. And how they relate together and how they trust each other is important. And, you know, that was, maybe externally doesn't seem very important, but internally, day in and day out, that calmness, that integrity really allowed us, I think, to be a good campaign.
Two incidences in here where he was not terribly pleased with you.
Well, sure. I mean, I think that something that got a good amount of coverage during the campaign was, you know, an opposition research memo was released talking about some of Senator Clinton's comments and ties to the country of India. And, you know, he was not just upset about that. You know, he thought his campaign had let him down. That was not the kind of campaign he wanted to run. And there was another instance where we released a video that he thought we had not talked through properly. So
General John McCain, the Keene?
Charlie Keating, yeah, we put together a documentary, which, you know, he just thought we had not communicated properly with him about that. So he, one of the important roles he played in the campaign at the candidate level was to make sure the tone of the campaign. Now, obviously, he was responsible for his own comments day to day. But, you know, our advertising and what our surrogates were saying out there, he very wanted much to avoid kind of the snarkiness and sort of the cheap political language and try and have an elevated debate. Now, we ran a tough campaign, obviously, and we made some tough arguments on substance against our opponents. But I think most voters saw what we were doing, that it was in bounds. And I think it proves that you can win elections without going down the lowest of roads.
Framingham, Massachusetts. Rachel, on our independent line, you're on with David Plouffe.
Yes, hi, Mr. Plouffe. Thanks for taking my call. And I just wanted to ask you, do you think that you can pull off a win in 2012 without Acorn if they, you know, happen to drop out of the situation with all their indictments and all their problems?
By the way, I spent a lot of time in Framingham, Massachusetts, growing up. My grandmother lived there. Acorn wasn't part of our campaign. They weren't relevant to anything we did. You know, I think that there were some in the media and in the political community suggesting somehow that they had some significant role. None at all. We went out there as our campaign and registered millions of voters. Our volunteers went out there and talked to their neighbors and their colleagues. So they had no relevance in the campaign other than they became, I guess, a momentary distraction. But what's great about our campaign is, you know, we had millions of Americans who were knocking on doors, sending emails, making phone calls, and they're the ones that went out there and registered voters and did the voter turnout.
Dearborn, Michigan, Jim, Democrat.
Yeah, hello?
Jim, you're on. Please go ahead with your comment or question.
Yeah, I want to thank C-SPAN. This is my first time calling.